Ah! My forehead is huge!
I hate my ears.
Chaka, what the hell am I supposed to do with this? I mean, it's bad enough you're making me fake an ID, but at least give me something I can work with.
It's the only booth I could find. You've got all these, like, high-tech, jazzy-schmazzy computers in here. Just take out Mecha and the Penguin, it'll work. Come on.
Wait, I can.
It'll take, like, 2 seconds.
The boss will have my ass for this. It's illegal. It's against store policy.
Oh, but downloading pornography on company time's, like, all good, right?
Can I help you?
Yeah, I need to make some posters.
Well, let me see here.
Make me 22. 21 is, like, so obvious.
Oh, boy, I'm not made out of money.
Three? No. In the comic shop or whatever. Are you ever gonna ask that girl out?
I gotta find the right moment.
Right moment, my ass. What about now? She's, like, right over there.
What? No, not now. No way. I'm not in the right mindset.
Oh, God.
Alex, we got a print job here. Can you take care of it? He's the expert. I just own the place.
Can I help you?
So you're the expert, huh?
You might say that.
This has to be just right. I want the ink blood red, not, you know, orangey.
This is, really cool. Are you involved with this? So how many copies do you want?
Ugh, my bro, the sex machine.
You see, you're gonna have a problem with this one. The plastic is just too thin for New York. Any common bouncer will spot this in a second. What you need is a Florida driver's license, because they really are laminated cheaper. U.S. military. This should get you in a lot of trouble, but... It usually works. Canadian. Perfect, but humiliating.
I hear the best way to break in an ID is in a restaurant. You know, order a lot of food and sneak in a drink.
Oldest trick in the book. Works, though. What do you say? Wanna grab a burger? I'm hungry.
Ugh, vile.
Yeah, meat is so vile.
I meant fruity.
Talking vile, you guys hear about that Malaysian place that just opened up on First? I hear they serve fried slugs.
Matt, come on now, that's nasty.
Ugh, puke!
What's wrong with fried slugs? They're no worse than charred cow or processed pig guts.
Oof.
That's hot dogs to you.
Oh, yeah, but hot dogs taste good. Snails, on the other hand, ugh.
What's the matter? You scared? Bacak!
Fruity not scared. Fruity smart.
yeah, well, whatever, Fruity. I'm not scared. I'd try them. How about you, Mecca?
No way.
What? Matt, I know you'd eat them.
Nah, I think I'll pass.
What do you think? You want to check this place out? Seems like we're the only ones with any balls around here.
I bet you eat those too.
Not nice, not nice at all.
I'm down. How about Saturday night? 9 o'clock?
Cool. Yeah, I should be up by then.
Hey, is it okay if I bring my brother along? He loves all that weird and exotic crap. And she's all like, sure, why not? Oh, plus I told you you'd insist on paying.
Oh, Chaka, I don't know if I...
Don't sweat it. I made you look good. Now you get to go out with Serena without even asking her. You owe me big time.
Oh, God, I can't believe what you did. Do you know what you did? I can't believe what you did. Oh, my... You didn't tell her I'm the guy from the copy shop, did you?
Ugh, of course not. Do you want me to ruin you?
Oh, man.
And after dinner, I'll make up some excuse to cut out and leave you guys alone? Genius, huh?
Oh, I'm gonna vomit.
What's wrong with you? God, can't you chow on a few fried slugs for the chance to be with your woman?
The slugs are no problem, but I don't know. I mean, what am I gonna say?
That's the beauty part. You don't have to say anything. We'll all be too busy gagging to talk.
Well, I mean, it's just a little get-together. It's not exactly like a real date,
no,
you know?
No, I mean, it's not like a date. It's just casual, right? I mean,
yeah.
It's just a casual exercise in utter humiliation.
Jen, I'm okay. I can handle it.
You have nothing in common with this girl. What can you possibly have to talk about?
There's such a thing as universals. Hello. Life makes no value judgments. It is up to us to decide what course of action to take. Another slug.
I had no idea your brother was so fascinating and perceptive.
He is pretty cool.
Universals, huh?
Yeah, you know, philosophy and crap. Life.
What's he babbling about? I can't even believe we're related.
You're gonna make a total idiot of yourself, and you know it, but you're still gonna walk right in and take what's coming to you.
There's nothing to fear but fear itself.
Oh, I beg to differ. You could drop food in your lap, forget to put on deodorant that day, spit in Serena's face while you talk.
You're not helping here.
And where you ever got the idea you'd hit it off with a vampire is beyond me.
Now, for your information, she's not a vampire. She just likes to dress that way.
Oh, I'm sorry. All pallid, pouty people look alike to me.
Plus, she's a very talented zither player.
Which you know all about and love so much. You realize you're really gonna humiliate yourself.
Hey, thanks, man. I really needed that positive reinforcement.
No problem. Glad to be of service. Stop by anytime. Good luck on your date.
Black hole, the common metaphors linking world religions.
A joke I heard the other day on Howard Stern.
I will go now.
Leave you alone.
I am so intoxicated
by your charm.
I feel like I'm floating,
fainting,
or riding a carousel.
Let us merge our souls.
Would you like a breadstick?
I sure would.
Isn't this Freudian?
It sure is.
Slimy.
I am concerned about our situation.
Follow me and your cares will subside.
My enveloping womanness awaits.
Wow. Your antennae are really long.
Serena,
wait.
I'm right behind you.
Oh no, I'm stuck.
I'm stuck.
Don't go.
Damn this sticky, viscous goo.
Coming.
Fine, fine.
Well, I hope so. You're using expensive paper. There's a customer. Why don't you handle it?
You look like hell.
Oh, gee, thanks. How come you can never say that to a girl? You look like hell today, Jen.
Thank you. You know, I think that's the first time you referred to me as a girl and not as, like, the asexual friend that you have.
Oh, well.
You know, so, I mean, how come you look like death warmed over? What, are you trying to appeal to the vampire chick?
I told you, she's not a vampire.
Oh.
She's a goth.
Right.
She's high-end.
High-end goth.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I woke up last night, and that's why I look like hell. I couldn't get back to sleep. It's no big deal.
Yeah, I know. I've been trying to get a good night's sleep since puberty. Try warm milk and turkey before bed. The tryptophans will put you right to sleep.
I mean, it's not that. It's really nothing. It's just one night.
One night? One night, well, that's how it starts, you see? But then the next night, you want to sleep even more desperately, which makes it even much less likely. And then pretty soon it's this never-ending hell of restless nights and washed-out days like Night of the Living Dead. The key is to put it right out of your mind. Start obsessing and you're screwed.
Yeah, you're definitely right.
You start to think, your mind starts to go, how do I function? I mean, will I ever sleep again? What's that sound? Oh my God, is there a problem in the house? What's a bed bug? Oh my God, it's 3 a.m., it's 4 a.m., it's 5 a.m.
So I can count, Jenny.
You know what helps? Counting back from 100 sometimes works. That'll put you right out. But if that doesn't work, you can try the home shopping channel, you know, Matlock if you're really, really desperate.
What's wrong with Matlock? He's crafty.
You know,
I
don't know, Jake and the Fat Man is good. And when all else fails, clean the bathtub. Even if you can't sleep, there'll be a clean bathtub waiting for you in the morning.
All right, I appreciate the advice, but this is no big deal.
Don't blame me when the torture begins. But, like I said, best not to think about it.
Thanks. Thanks for your help. But I don't think I'll have any trouble sleeping tonight.
Hello. Who's there?
Hey, Alex.
Oh, hi, Jen.
You awake?
I'm awake now.
Can't sleep?
I finally dozed off, but then the phone rang.
Sorry. I figured you'd be up, and I just had to unload on a fellow insomniac. Leah brought this guy back, and they are having the loudest sex I ever heard. She's making all these fake-o noises. But what really kills me is that, can you keep it down? When she was getting ready to go out, she was telling me all about her date.
He has a Lexus. Not the low-end kind, but the high-end kind. And he does some Wall Street job where you make money when the stocks go up and when they go down.
Sounds like he could be the one.
Oh, but he has the tiniest little thing. I mean, I can hardly find it. Remember Jeff? His was the biggest. He had to wear those mega condoms or whatever. Most guys are in the middle. Not that it matters to me, since I really don't like sex very much.
Really? But what about all those noises you make?
Jen, guys expect that. Especially if you order appetizers. Oh, I don't know if I can even describe his. It's kind of like...
So, she looks like she's trying to remember how, you know, non-massive he was. And then, she gets a bright idea. One of the few in her life, I might add. She stares at her lipstick, she takes it and...
Let me make sure.
And then she puts it in her mouth.
Oh yeah, that's about right.
Can you beat that? And now she's acting all like, with Larry lipstick in there. And you should have seen the one she brought home last week. You won't believe this. I mean, he...
Yeah. You're kidding. Where does she find them? Yeah.
Hey, sounds like they've finally passed out. Thanks, Alex. I think I can finally get some sleep. I'm tired.
Oh, lucky you. I've been up like 36 hours. I'm starting to see things. Whatever. Bye.
Better rule!
Pretty cool, huh? And only $2.
Get away from me. Get away! Oh, I know what you're up to! You can't fool me! No! Not again!
Apple pie with that?
No!
Just coffee.
Do I know you? I've seen your face somewheres. It must have been one of those lists in the post office.
I don't think so.
Don't worry about me, sweetie. I wouldn't call police on paying customer.
Maybe I will have that apple pie.
Good boy.
Hey, Alex, man, you look like I should feel. Seeing as how I woke up with a new tattoo next to a girl who looks like ass.
And I'm just a little out of it. I didn't get any sleep last night.
Nice shooting, Tex. I'm happy for you. How's it feel to be a man?
Hey, I've had chicks before, all right? But nah, wasn't like that. I had insomnia.
Damn, man. I thought you finally got something. Oh, well. Should I make a separate pile for the Canadians?
Ready for the big night?
Dinner with Serena and the Slugs, remember?
Tonight? Saturday? Damn! Of course I know, Chaka. And there's no way. I'm sorry.
I knew you'd bail.
I'm not bailing. I've been up for 2 nights in a row. I'm sorry.
I haven't.
Yeah, but you sleep all day.
After all I went through, I can't believe you'd blow it. You don't deserve Serena. You can stay home with your fists of fury. We'll eat our slugs, and then maybe the two of us will go out and pick up some real men.
Brothers of Creation? Whoa, he knows them?
Well, just the drummer. But since they were in town, he felt like he had to hang out. He was pretty bummed.
So am I. Now he's gonna pay for dinner.
Oh, I bet he'll want to pick up the tab anyway. He's like that.
They've got some bizarre things here. This caramelized frog? Do you think it's like a whole frog?
Apparently.
Ladies, your trang pangaloon. Do you prefer them with it or without the heads?
Which end is the head?
With the heads, please.
So I blew it. At least I'll finally be able to get some sleep.
Yeah, probably.
Wait, what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Just don't start obsessing, okay?
I'm not.
Count sheep. Don't start counting all the things you did wrong.
All what things? I didn't do anything wrong. You don't think I'm gonna get another chance with Serena, do you? Huh? Admit it!
Alex, settle down.
Alright. I don't know. I'll talk to you later, alright? Hey, look at me! Alex Henson, Manhattan's number one loser!
Oh, yeah? Look at me! Constantine Batsoff! I'm Manhattan's number one loser!
Not me. I gotta sleep.
Hello? I know you from somewhere, don't I?
I really don't think so.
What's with the smile?
Smile?
Wait a minute, the coffee shop. You're doing our poster. Hey, this is where we're having the event.
Event?
Event, yeah, I know. Stupid word. Just a bunch of freaks parading around.
No, it's a good word. I mean, I've run from normal people because they look so strange.
I totally know what you mean.
Do you? Do you know about the slugs, too?
The slugs? God, that's so weird. I ate slugs tonight.
I know. You and my sister.
You know. Wait, you're Chaka's brother.
Aren't we all Chaka's brother?
Well, yeah, of course we are. But I mean, you really are. And you're the guy who knows brothers of creation.
Sometimes it feels like there are too many brothers and sisters. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. It's true, though.
Oh, God. Hey, you know, you owe me $49 for dinner. Slugs are expensive. Hey. Hello? National Merit Scholar. Here's a 10. Keep the change.
And I was walking and walking, but this time it was all really beautiful somehow. And I felt like I was like part of it, you know?
Yeah.
And then, like I said, I was in this place with Serena and...
And then you just woke up in your own sticky bed. No idea how you got there? You were dreaming, Alex.
No, it wasn't a dream. It was...
Drugs.
No. Maybe it was a dream.
Damn it, I'm late for work again. See ya.
Yeah, I should take off too. Gotta meet a hottie for some falafel. Anyway, sorry you didn't hook up with Serena. Maybe next time you won't choke so bad. Laters.
Hi, Alex. You got home all right?
Serena, hi. Yeah, I mean, that's where I woke up,
So I guess I must have.
Hey, you know, I had a great time hanging out with you. I had no idea you were a night owl like me. Oh, are my posters ready?
Oh, yeah. I mean, no. You see, I used too much red ink on the lettering. I'm such an idiot.
Whoa, I like it. It's all dreamy and distorted. This is great.
Great?
Here you go. I don't know, you know, if you're into this kind of thing, but maybe if you'd like to come. You know, I didn't know you only dress like this because you have to. I mean, because of your job. I thought you were some kind of geek or something. I didn't realize you had so much weird, cool stuff going on in your head.
Me? Well, yeah. I mean, that'd be great. Say Friday. 5 sleepless nights. That should be just enough time.